generally speaking, anti-differentiating things with radicals is difficult.
For example, let's try to find an antiderivative of x over the cube root of x plus 1 dx, right? Let's try to anti-differentiate this.
Can I make a substitution to improve the integrand?
So what substitution do I want to make? Well, I really have some choices. I mean, one thing I could do is I could make u x plus 1, and in that case, du is just dx, and if u is x plus 1, then x is u minus 1, and I can then rewrite this anti-differentiation problem. Instead, this becomes the antiderivative of not x, but u minus 1, still cube root, but instead of x plus 1, it's now of u, and the dx becomes du. And I could actually do this,
but I'm not going to head down that path. Instead, I want to show you a trick by which you can get rid of the radical altogether.
So instead, let's set u just to grab the whole denominator. So u will be the cube root of x plus 1. And in that case, u cubed is x plus 1, or in other words, x is u cubed minus 1. And that tells me what dx is. In that case, dx is 3u squared du. Now I could make this substitution. This transforms this integration problem to the antiderivative of x now becomes u cubed minus 1. The whole denominator just becomes u, and then the dx here is now a 3u squared du. So I'll write 3u squared du.
And that's just a polynomial.
So I'll simplify this a bit. This is the antiderivative of, what is this here? U cubed over u times 3u squared, that's 3u to the fourth, minus 1 over u times 3u squared, that's minus 3u du. And this is just a polynomial, so I can anti-differentiate this very quickly. This antiderivative is 3/5 u to the fifth minus 3/2 u squared plus c.
Now we'll just replace u with what it equals in terms of x.
So u, remember, is the cube root of x plus 1, so putting that in here, I get 3/5, instead of u, it's x plus 1 to the 1/3 to the 5th, so to the 5/3 power, minus 3/2 x plus 1 to the 1/3 squared, which is to the 2/3 power, plus c.
To make it easy to talk about this particular technique, it has a name.
The rationalizing substitution. The original problem had a cube root in it, but I made a substitution to get rid of the radical, of rationalizing.
A challenge with doing u-substitutions is that there really are multiple paths that you can take to the correct answer. It's not even apparent how successful a particular substitution might be until after you've started applying it, right? You have to take that first bite before you realize whether or not you're eating food.